hidup tiadalah mungkin tanpa perjuangan, tanpa pengorbanan mulia adanya. Hidup tiadalah mungkin tanpa perjuangan, tanpa pengorbanan mulia adanya. Berpegangan tangan, satu dalam cita demi masa depan Indonesia jaya. Indonesia jaya.
Kami meninggalkan tanah air pada tanggal 1 April yang lalu, kami menyerahkan keselamatan negara, tanah air, dan bangsa ini kepada seluruh rakyat Indonesia. Selama kami di luar negeri, kami memperhatikan benih.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to start this event. First of all, I would like to invite everyone to turn on your camera and please mute your microphone. Good afternoon. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Shalom, Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya. Greeting to all of us. Honorable Secretary of Human Resources Development Agency on Transportation, Gi Hartiman. Head of Center for Human Resources Development on Civil Aviation, Mr. Harry Sudarmaji. Distinguished Ms. Julie Lewis, First Secretary Transport, Australian Embassy, Jakarta. Official of the Ministry of Transportation of Indonesia. Official of the Australian Embassy in Jakarta, and all cadet and participant, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Gina, and it is precious change for me to be your master of ceremony on this very special event. First of all, let us thank God who has been giving us his blessing and mercy so that we could gather in this very wonderful event. I am pleased to welcome you all to Ambassadorial Lecture that conducted virtually in cooperation between Ministry of Transportation of Indonesia and Australian Embassy in Jakarta. I also would like to welcome First Secretary Transport Australian Embassy Jakarta, Ms. Julie Lewis. In today's event, she will deliver her presentation with very interesting topic named Enhancing Transport Security Awareness. On this wonderful event, we have several agendas as follow: opening, and then singing Indonesia national anthem, and then opening remarks from Secretary of Human Resources Development Agency on Transportation, Mr. Yugi Hartiman. And then the main agenda is lecture by First Secretary Transport Australian Embassy Jakarta, Ms. Julie Lewis. And then few from our discussion, Head of Center for Human Resources Development on Civil Aviation, Mr. Heri Sudarmaji. And finally, we have a discussion and closing. Ladies and gentlemen, starting this event, let's stand together to sing Indonesia National Anthem. I would like to invite all the participants, ladies and gentlemen, to stand up. To all the participants, please kindly have a seat. The next agenda is opening remarks that will be delivered by the Secretary of Human Resources Development Agency on Transportation, and also to officially open this ambassadorial lecture, Mr. Yugi Hartiman, the time is yours.
Thank you, Gina. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me representing the head of Human Resources Development Agency on Transportation to give an opening remark at ambassadorial lecture this evening. The title is Enhancing Awareness, Friday 26th of February 2021. Her Excellency Mrs. Julie Lewis, First Secretary Transport, Australian Embassy Jakarta, Honorable Official of Minister of Transportation Jakarta, and Official of the Embassy of Australia to Indonesia in Jakarta, cadet, participant, guest, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A very good afternoon to everyone. It is a wonderful, in this wonderful afternoon, let us praise to God Almighty for all His blessing that we could gather here. It is a great pleasure for me to deliver this welcome speech on behalf of the Minister of Transportation. I'm pleased to welcome everyone of you to this important ambassadorial lecture entitled Enhancing Transport Security Awareness. Let me start by thanking to Her Excellency, the First Secretary Transport of Australian Embassy in Jakarta, Mrs. Julie Lewis. We appreciate and pleased to organize this lecture in collaboration with such a valuable speaker. Ladies and gentlemen, this lecture is conducted virtually by the Human Resources Development Agency on Transportation, in collaboration with the Australian Embassy, which is addressed to all participants, including our cadets, to give an international views and on the management of transportation in the advanced countries such as Australia. I would like also also introduce our agency to the official of the Embassy of Australia in Jakarta. The Human Resources and Development Agency on Transportation is one institution under the Ministry of Transportation, which is responsible to develop human resources on land transportation, like road transport and rail transport, and sea transportation, and also civil aviation. Our agency is managing 27 education and training institutions with more than 22,000 cadets studying in our institution. Actually, they stay in a campus dormitory, and some of them currently on the job training in the industries of transportation. One of our strategy is to enhance the value of our graduate in the national and international transportation industry is through improvement of quality and competencies of our cadet. Fulfillment of the national and international standard, also one of the most important thing to be focused on. Cooperation and collaboration with the embassy and international partner could be the excellent option. As our mission is to be to improve the quality of transportation services that are reliable, convenient, efficient, safe, and sustainable, we need to encourage young people, especially our cadet, to be a professional, capable, and also innovative. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope this ambassadorial lecture could help our cadets to be able to expand their knowledge, help them to gain more information, as well as increase their awareness on the national, on the international transportation system, especially transportation system in Australia. To ensure the transportation system comply to the standard of safety and security, we need human resources who have competency and understand the current national and international regulation and practices. It is needed. It is indeed a proud a privilege to have Her Excellency, Mrs. Julie Lewis. We will share valuable insight about how Australia enhance the transportation security awareness, as well as on how to develop and manage the transportation system. For cadet, I hope you all could gain the knowledge and expand your understanding about a transportation system in Australia, as well as in other countries. Our event today would be a notable one, since we have important and competent speaker. This is a good start for us to exchange our knowledge and experience about the current transportation condition. I hope our moderator today can facilitate to build a productive and fruitful discussion. Once again, I think Mrs. Julie Lewis, an official and of Australia Embassy in Jakarta, for making this event possible. Many thanks to Mrs. Julie Lewis and all official of Australian Embassy in Jakarta for making this event possible. I hope there always be a synergy and mutually beneficial cooperation and collaboration between Indonesia and Australia, and we look forward to our continued partnership. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Yugi Hartiman, for the speech and officially open this event. And the next, we are proceed to our main session this afternoon, that is ambassadorial lecture by First Secretary Transport Australian Embassy Jakarta, Ms. Julie Lewis, and Head of Center for Human Resources Development on Civil Aviation, Mr. Harry Sudarmaji, as a discussion, and it will be guided by the moderator, Mr. Geni Prasojo from Indonesia Civil Pilot Academy. Mr. Geni Prasojo, the time is yours.
Thank you, Ms. Gina. Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, and greetings for our wealthy and healthiness. To His Excellency Mr. Masrono Yudhi Hartiman as the Secretary of Human Resources Development of Transportation Agency, Ministry of Transportation. The Honorable Ms. Julie Lewis, the First Secretary of Transport at Australian Embassy Jakarta, as the presenter this afternoon. How are you, Ms. Lewis? Okay. Yes. Nice to meet you. Thank you. The Honorable Mr. Harry Sudarmaji, the Head of Air Transportation Human Resources Development Center, as the discussion today. Welcome, Mr. Harry. The Honorable all the heads of Human Resources Development Center and the Honorable all of the Director of Polytechnics, Director of Academy as well. And also all the distinguished guests and our beloved cadets of the transportation who has joined this webinar this afternoon. First of all, let us give a high gratitude to the Almighty God, Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala. Upon His mercy and blessing, we can gather together in well condition and prime condition. Ladies and gentlemen, safety and security improvement in public transportation in every country is very important. Public transportation poses a higher risk of safety and security since there happen to be more passengers in transportation mode. The problem becomes worse because of lack suitable and integrated approaches. The question is why security awareness is so important. Perhaps we all already curious about the answer. Before we start the presentation, allow me to read the curriculum vitae of our honorable presenter, Ms. Julie Lewis. I will read the curriculum vitae of the presenter. Okay. Ms. Julie Lewis, the First Secretary of Transport, Aviation and Maritime Security Division, Department of Home Affairs. Julie has worked in aviation and maritime security since 2011. During this time, Julie has led international capacity building teams and completed a 3-year posting to Bangkok, Thailand. In her current role as the First Secretary of Transport, Julie represents the Department of Home Affairs and the Australian government. Julie is responsible to the Australia-Indonesia Cooperation on Transport Security, as well as engagement with Singapore, Brunei, and Timor-Leste. Immediately prior to taking up her current position, Julie conducted international assessment at Australia's last ports of call airports. Prior to joining the department, Julie worked within the Australian Attorney General Department in the Counter-Terrorism and Emergency Management Branch, and has held previous roles at the Australian Trade Commission and the Office of the Minister of Foreign Affairs and Trade. That is the curriculum vitae of Ms. Julie. Very interesting, yeah. So now we have already cannot resist that to hear the presentation of Ms. Julie. So let us invite Ms. Lewis to give her insight for us. For Ms. Lewis, the time is yours. Thank you.
Terima kasih Pak Jerry. Selamat siang.
Selamat siang.
Bapak Kerry and Bapak Jerry and Bapak Yugi. Terima kasih and hello to all students. Thank you so much for having me here today. I will be delivering in English. I do have my senior program manager who can translate if you do need that at any time. On behalf of the Australian Government's Department of Home Affairs and the Australian Embassy Jakarta, it is my pleasure to be with you to deliver today's ambassadorial lecture on enhancing transport security awareness. As you have just heard, I hold the position of First Secretary Transport at the Australian Embassy in Jakarta. What does that involve? I think the best way to describe my role is that of engagement. Engagement with Australia's partners to enhance international transport security standards across our region. Despite having worked in specific technical areas, my position here is somewhat generalist. I work across a range of transport security areas and provide a conduit between Australia and our partners to progress areas of mutual interest and to support information sharing. My first position in aviation and maritime security, which was 10 years ago, was leading the team in Canberra, Australia, on the Australia-Indonesia capacity building program. To be now in Jakarta and leading the delivery of our work together here is an absolute privilege. I'm especially pleased to be here with you today, as my background is in training and development, and I firmly believe that this is the cornerstone to achieving sustainable results in our transport security environment. I'm quite amazed that there are over 22,000 students at the academy, so I'm a little intimidated. The Australian government has been working collaboratively with the Indonesian Ministry of Transport for over 15 years. We work together to strengthen transport security in our region. Close geographic neighbours, our transport industries are closely linked through the movement of people and goods and through trade and investment. Protecting our transport industries and our travelling public is a high priority for both of our countries. The Australian government established an aviation and maritime security presence at post in the Australia. Sorry?
Do you want me to start the presentation now?
Oh, yes. Sorry. My apologies. I was looking at my presentation, but I don't think you have. Okay.
Wait.
That's it. The Australian government established an aviation and maritime security office within the embassy here in Jakarta in 2005. Our engagement with Indonesia since then has matured into an ongoing cooperative and collaborative relationship with a specific focus on transport security capacity building. The relationship between Australia and Indonesia has been underpinned by a memorandum of understanding. In February 2020, the terms of the Australia-Indonesia MOU on transport security were renewed, agreed, and signed by the ministers in Canberra in the presence of the Indonesian President and the Australian Prime Minister. Australia puts a high value on our MOU and our ongoing work with Indonesia. We are very proud of the achievements that we have made under the Australia-Indonesia Transport Security Cooperation Program, which is across both aviation and maritime security. The relationship between my department, the Department of Home Affairs, and the Ministry of Transportation is a great example of bilateral cooperation working toward a common goal. We have collaborated on policy and standards, quality assurance, air cargo, threat and risk, identity security, trusted insider training, government support, English language training, security awareness, both in the aviation and the maritime sectors. The transport system is of vital importance to our region. The economic and strategic importance of our vessels, aircraft, ports, airports, routes, straits, and sea lanes cannot be overstated. A reach to meet current and future challenges. This cooperation must involve all sectors, government regulators, operators, and industry. The complexity of our operations will grow, commensurate with the commodity and passenger volumes. The threat of terrorism and criminality is also growing and evolving. Our ports and our airports and our critical national infrastructure all remain highly attractive targets. Why is the transport sector such an attractive target for terrorist attacks? Because an attack on a cruise ship, aircraft, or airport has the ability to inflict mass casualties, to inflict damage to the economy, to disrupt public confidence in travel. It's an attractive, high-profile incident, a symbolic statement that can generate sensational media imagery, and it generates public anxiety. The cruise industry is an attractive target. The nature of the industry's operations presents opportunities that could be exploited. The impact on tourism and the subsequent economic fallout from an attack would be significant. The Achille Lauro hijacking led to a sharp decline in Mediterranean cruises. In Tunisia, the Sousse Beach attack further resulted in a decrease of European visitors. The effects of a terrorist attack are felt far and wide. They linger long after the initial horror experienced at the time of the incident. The aviation industry is, of course, an attractive target for terrorists, and many attacks have contributed to the evolution of our security measures. 9/11 opened a new chapter in threats and responses to aviation security. The post 9/11 aviation security environment shifted to address suicide attacks, including the use of aircraft as an instrument of terror and destruction. Not all threats are terrorist-based, of course. When developing our security measures, we need to consider many forms of attack to best protect our people and our infrastructure. Threats may come from terrorists, criminals, piracy, civil disorder, disgruntled employees, activists. A risk-based layered approach to security assists us in implementing effective security arrangements to deter and detect unlawful behaviour. Risk assessments, access control, screening, patrols, and CCTV are examples of layers of preventive security. Building a security-conscious transport community provides an additional preventive layer to our transport security arrangements. The eyes and ears of the people that travel through, dine at, clean, or work at our transport hubs can be a valuable detection and deterrent layer. ICAO, the International Civil Aviation Organization's Year of Security Culture 2020, has been extended into 2021. This initiative encourages organizations and industries around the globe to promote aviation security culture. This is a great initiative that we should apply to the whole of the transport network, not just our aviation sector. Security culture is an area that Australia and Indonesia have been actively involved in for a number of years. It is an area that requires ongoing effort and attention to maintain the benefits. We hear the terms security awareness and security culture often, and they're often interchanged. But what do we mean? The Cambridge Dictionary describes awareness as knowledge that something exists, an understanding of a situation or subject at the present time based on information or experience. Culture is described as the way of life, general customs and beliefs of a particular group of people at a particular time. I think if we aim to provide our people with a sound understanding of transport security and the value of them being involved in this process, we can build a security-aware culture where security is not an additional thought, but a way of life, a way of work. A strong security awareness culture is crucially important to addressing current and emerging threats. Vigilance by our staff, transport stakeholders, and the general community is a key element in a holistic security regime. There's no right or wrong way to achieve security awareness. Our environments differ. Culture, scale, access to technology, threat, tolerance to risk, budgets, the list goes on. However, there is significant experience in the region and around the globe that we can learn from, and our continual collaborative efforts and information sharing enhances our regional outcomes. It is events like this that provide us with the opportunity to share information and to remind each other of our common goals. Building a strong security awareness can enhance the detection, reporting, and resolution of suspicious and criminal activity in our transport sector. It can improve the security and crime prevention culture across our transport sector. How do we develop a security culture or enhance security awareness? This is about engaging staff at all levels of organisation to embrace common values and consider security as a priority in all of their work, all of the time. The transport community puts emphasis on the importance of a layered approach. When it comes to security, for example, in aviation, various measures are put in place, from advanced passenger information review through to the screening process and onto the securing of cockpit doors. But are we utilising one of the most valuable assets of our airports? Our people. In the public areas of airports and ports, screening is impractical and we rely heavily on surveillance and patrols. In secure areas, there is much more greater control since we know that people are either passengers or they have permission or authorization to be there. A comprehensive approach to security, therefore, relies heavily on people. An effective security culture is fundamental to keeping an entity and its personnel safe from threats. A healthy and strong security culture helps to increase internal and external trust. It creates consistent positive behaviour and engages productively with risk. Through the development of an active security culture, the threat to an organisation and its assets can be significantly decreased, highlighting why it is the responsibility of everyone from the top down to make security a priority. So how do we build a culture of security awareness? How do we maintain that culture and optimise it so that threats are identified, reported and resolved? We can do this through raising security awareness through training and education, creating and implementing programs, utilizing our resources, and encouraging the whole of the airport or port community to be involved, to be aware. Suspicious activity reporting program harnesses a security aware community, and it is established to foster a security aware culture to support the identification and reporting of suspicious activities through the provision of an effective reporting system. And it includes response options, data collection, and information sharing. A suspicious activity identification program engages the eyes and ears of the airport or port community. Through information sharing, as well as analysis and investigations, it enhances a preventive transport security regime and a national program that enables increased intelligence and enhanced response capability. Talk about suspicious activity identification, but what is suspicious activity? Your understanding of suspicious activity may be very different to mine. When establishing a program or developing training material, organizations need to clarify what they mean by suspicious activity so that there is a common understanding. Suspicious activity can be defined as any observed behavior that could indicate terrorism or terrorism-related crime. Suspicious activity can also be defined as the actions of an individual or group that is outside the normal acceptable standards for those people or that particular area. This definition is taken from the Guide to Developing and Implementing a Suspicious Activity Identification Program at Ports. Two guidance booklets, one maritime, one aviation, were developed through the Maritime and Aviation Security Awareness Workshops Project back in 2014. This was a collaboration of Southeast Asia nations. Indonesia and Australia played an important role in the conduct of that project and the development of resources. Developing easy reference cards to support a suspicious activity program is useful in providing staff and members of our community with a tool to assist them in identifying what is a suspicious activity. This HOT principle is an example of such a tool where people can use this short list to consider, is the item hidden? Is there an item that's obviously suspicious? Is there an item not typical of the area? Is the person trying to hide their actions? Are their actions obviously suspicious? Are their actions not typical of the area? It is important to remember, that's just another example of a reference card for people to use. Next slide. It's important to remember that factors such as race, ethnicity, and/or religious affiliation are not suspicious. Campaigns such as if you see something, say something, emphasize behavior rather than appearance in identifying suspicious activity. Behavior that is reasonably indicative of criminal activity related to terrorism should be shared through appropriate channels. So I have talked very briefly about security awareness, the importance of our community becoming security aware, to building a security culture within the transport sector. I'm very interested in your thoughts on security awareness. Do Do you think we have a strong security aware culture? I would like to conclude today by asking you, when you go back to your workplace, to take some time to consider how you might contribute to enhancing transport security awareness in your own studies, your work, or your personal life. How can we make security awareness a way of life? And remember, if you see or hear something suspicious, report it. Terimakasi.
So they just send me the list. Oh. Yeah, they just send me the list that I'm going to read for you so then you can respond.
Thank you, Ms. Lewis. Nice topics and nice presentation. It's very useful for us. So give applause to Ms. Lewis from your position. Yeah, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. So that's why aviation security is very important in real life. So there is a highlight that I can deliver to you that how do we develop culture security awareness with training and education and info sharing and etc. And also suspicious activities identification programs that delivered by Ms. Lewis by the HOT principle. Yeah, height direction, obviously suspicious and typically something. And then, and also the quotes from Ms. Lewis, if you see something, say something and report it also. Okay. That's the presentation session from Ms. Lewis. So now lecturer. So I will give the chance for the name of cadets from Sophie from study program management lalu lintas udara or traffic control management from Poltek Bank Jayapura. For Sophie, the cadet Sophie.
Yes. Thank you before. I have some question that what do you think about transport security awareness in Indonesia and do you have any suggestion to enhance transport security awareness in Indonesia?
29, we have working closely with the DCA.
Thank you, Sophie, for your question.
Okay.
Security awareness in Indonesia? I can say that Indonesia and Australia have worked together on security awareness for years. It's not something new for either of our countries, and I'm pleased to say that. So when ICAO announced that 2020 was the year of security culture, I think both Australia and Indonesia could say, we're already dealing with that. We're already progressing and thinking about how we can build that that culture. When we had the workshops project that I referred to that actually developed these books, Indonesia was a co-presenter on this project, and Bali Airport was a topic of discussion because they were at the time working on their own suspicious activity program. We are looking forward to working with the DGCA and the airports on doing further work in security awareness. As I said, it's something that we need to keep working on. We need to keep paying attention and we need to keep people aware. We have some very good products, but it's important that we continue to update that. So we have worked together with both DGCA and DGST, KPLP, on security awareness projects. In fact, was it 2019,
yes.
There was an extensive project with KPLP on improving awareness culture at ports. It was a very successful program. So I think in answer to your question, I think Indonesia has a commitment and enthusiasm and extensive work in this field. And I really look forward to working beside the DGCA to continue that work.
that's all. Do you have any suggestion to enhance the intersection?
And just, I'll just raise on the suggestion to enhance transport security awareness in Indonesia. That is simply to keep working. We all need to just keep working and also sharing information. I think opportunities like this is improving our transport security awareness. You have 1,000 participants. I expect that the cadets are very security aware, but having these conversations together allows us to prioritise these type of things. I also know that Indonesia is already focusing on how to take forward the ICAO year of security culture and how they can launch and implement that here.
Yeah, I think that's all.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Lewis. Hopefully that is answer your question, Cadet Sophie. And I'm sorry, Ms. Lewis, I will read the name of the questions. There are three more questions. First from PPI Curug, name is Naura from Diploma 4, Air Traffic Controller. And the second is Irfan, Cadet Irfan from Pilot Cadets, non-diploma. From API Banyuwangi, and then the third is Cadet Irlan Patapuri from API Banyuwangi. There are three questions for the questions session. So the time is yours, Ms. Lewis.
For the cadets,
for Cadets Naura. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
No, okay.
Yes, okay. Of course. Okay, good afternoon, Miss. Firstly, I want to say thank you for opportunities. And as we know, in this modern era, machinery and automations available has a critical role in transportation security. On the other hand, human factors often pose some threats to transportation security, resulting in incident and accidents. And my question is it possible that in the future, machinery and automations made by humans could 100% replace humans' role in creating transportation safety and security? Thank you.
Okay, this is the first question.
That's another very good question. Thank you, Nora. I think it's something that we could probably spend a lot of time talking about. But look, machinery equipment is integral to the work that we do, and it is improving all of the time, not only to implement better security measures, but also to make the flow through an airport or a port for our passengers a nicer experience. So as we all know, security is not necessarily welcomed by our passengers. It can be an inconvenience. So things like quicker screening lanes and body scanners and liquid scanners, things like that can make my travel through an airport as a passenger easier. Can equipment replace people? I think this is a very personal opinion, and I would say no. I think great equipment, an airport or a port that is equipped with effective machinery and systems and processes, delivers outstanding security outcomes. However, I could install some very, very shiny equipment into an airport, and if our screeners and our security staff are not doing their job, that piece of equipment is not going to do it for them. I think a well-equipped airport makes our job easier, so we can have those effective machines to support what we do. And I see equipment continuing to support what we do, to make our job easier, to allow us to be more effective. What else do we have there?
Is it possible to replace Bayerman's like 100%?
Yeah, so I think no, but maybe in a very futuristic world, there might not be any people. And I think there is obviously a place for equipment in detecting human reactions. So when we're looking at suspicious activity, obviously we don't want our people that are working in the cafes trying to assess behavioural to conduct some behavioural analysis on our passengers. But just looking at people to see, is that suspicious? You know, it's a hot day in Bali and someone's wearing big woolen jackets. So that's kind of odd. That's a little suspicious. Maybe equipment can detect that, like temperatures. Like we're using right now with COVID, we have temperature machines everywhere and we respond to things very quickly. When we have an incident, whether it be the pandemic or a terrorist incident, in security, we have to respond and we have to evolve. So there might be equipment to test to gauge people's temperature level, anxiety levels. But I think when you have an airport that can often, or a port that is like a city or a shopping centre, the people that are there working, seeing everything. So if we can build that culture, that awareness, I'm not sure machines could do that. Does that answer your question, Nora?
Yeah, absolutely, yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
It's a really interesting conversation. Maybe we can have another one, another get together on that at another time.
Sure.
Thank you, Ms. Lewis, and thank you, Cadet Nora. The next question from Cadet Irfan from API Banyuwangi. Cadet Irfan, can you hear me? Okay. Please concise your questions. Go ahead.
For sure. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Ginilhong. Good afternoon, everyone. Commission, ladies and gentlemen. Let me introduce myself. My name is Muhammad Irfan Bashir Akbar. I'm from Indonesian Civil Pilot Academy, a program study pilot fixed wing. Sorry, Mrs. Lewis. Yeah, my question is very simple, but it's important for us. It is what should we do as a student for realizing and sensing security awareness in this era, especially in this during this pandemic.
Okay, enhancing security awareness in this pandemic. Go ahead, Ms. Lewis. Thank you.
You describe your question as simple, but it's a very big question. What you can do as a student, and I think, look, I'm really interested in what you can do as a student too. Like, to think that there are 1,000 students dialing in today to think about security awareness. If only half of the cadets can contribute one idea, that's a lot of ideas. And I'm sure there would be some there that we have not thought of. But I think what you can do, what each of us can do, is just start thinking about what is security in my role, in my job? What is security? What level of security exists in my personal life? So, and even as a passenger, so you're all studying various areas, obviously, of transportation, but what about when you walk through an airport or you walk through a very busy bus station or a train station? Do you pay attention to this, what's happening around you? I know sometimes I don't, and I live and breathe security. So I think that's the first thing we can do, is start being aware in our own lives what's happening around us, just starting to be more observant and more mindful of what is happening, what are our surroundings. It's very easy to get caught up in the world and not notice things. And that's what security awareness is about. It's about paying attention and noticing what is happening. With regard to the pandemic, so the pandemic has obviously been a huge impact on transport, and of course transport security. And I think one of the challenges we will face is when the borders begin to open again. So they've been so quiet, travel has been so quiet for such a long time. Our airports, our regulators, our ports are all going to be suddenly having to get back into business. People have been not going to work so much. And you're at a training academy at the moment, and you know how important it is to maintain your studies. If you have a break in your studies, it's easy to lose or forget. And that security culture that we've built up, and that those skills that our staff have, may not be at the same standard as pre-COVID. So I think we have a lot of challenges, and I think security awareness is even more important when we start back up, because I think there'll be a lot of issues as we start back up. So we start, you know, airports are full of passengers again, and we have to work out security and COVID. So I'm not sure what that will look like. So obviously the airports are quiet at the moment, and they have the temperature and they have all the setup to deal with, you know, COVID paper checking and temperature checking. What will that look like in 6 months or whenever it is that the borders open? I'm not sure, but as security officers, we may well have to incorporate pandemic or safety measures with our security measures. So that's another challenge. But look, I'm not sure that I answered your question very well, but I think if we all take it on ourselves and look at security in our own lives, I think we can then roll that into our work and have benefits across the whole sector. Thank you.
Thank you. Is that answered the question? Cadet Irfan? Hopefully, yes. Yeah. Okay. So the next question is from Cadet Irlan Patapuri, from Indonesia Civil Pirate Academy at Banyuwangi. For Cadet Irlan, time is yours. Go ahead.
Good afternoon, everyone. Please permission to ask. My question is how to increase the awareness of the importance of transportation security. As we can see that there is still a lot of lack of public awareness of this situation. That's all. Thank you.
Okay. So what I did mention previously, that the average passenger doesn't necessarily love what we do. So we're the ones that make people take their laptops out of their bag. We take their drink bottles off them. We make them get in line to go through screening. You know, we're kind of annoying. So the public awareness of what we do is sometimes not in the best light. So what we do is for public safety, and it is in their best interests. But how do we make them aware of that while they're struggling with their bags in an airport? And that is something we've dealt with or grappled with for a long time. I think you're talking about promotional and awareness, marketing campaigns. So there are two things with security awareness. You could develop the suspicious activity program, which obviously brings all of the community, everyone that works in an airport, the community right on the border of the airport, into having a say in how we do our security. So that if people have ownership in a system, they tend to be more supportive of it. I think the only way to promote public awareness is, again, through forums like this, through advertising at events, suspicious activity programs. You would have pamphlets and things, so that brings people in to say, if you see something suspicious, here's a phone number, call us. But it is a difficult area. It's a difficult area because whilst people will acknowledge that security is there for their safety, it's not necessarily the easiest experience when as a traveler. I think all we can do is continue to promote what we do and why we do it and why it's important. Is that okay?
Yes, okay. Cadet Irlan, is that question, your question is already answered? Okay, thank you, Ms. Lewis. So there are three questions that delivered to me from the committee. From the first question is from the cadets, and so now the second session is from lecturer. The first lecturer that has been questioned to me, that Mr. Hemi Pamuraharjo from the airport operational at PPI Curug, Polytechnic Penerbangan Indonesia Curug, Aviation Polytechnic at Curug. For Mr. Hemi Pamuraharjo, the time is yours.
Thank you, moderator. Good afternoon. Ms. Lewis, First Secretary, Australian Embassy.
I know him.
Thank you for your excellent presentation. My name is Hemi Pamuraharjo from Indonesia Polytechnic Aviation Curug. During the decade, cyber aviation security being a comprehensive discussion across the world at any level forum. So in this case, I would like to have your point of view, since you have been here in Indonesia. How do you find the readiness of the Indonesian government in facing aviation cyber security? Is there anything that needs to be developed in terms of regulation or organization? Second, are there experiences that you could share for us to develop our aviation cyber security? Thank you, Ms. Lewis.
Thank you for that question. It's a great question, and it's a very popular area. Cybersecurity is a very interesting area, a popular area, and a very complex area. I will not even try to advise on what regulations need to be changed or adapted to manage cyber going forward. However, it is something that we have discussed, Australia and Indonesia has discussed, and Australia is currently, right now, going through legislation changes for our cybersecurity and infrastructure, critical infrastructure. We have spoken to DGCA, and we will be conducting a collaborative activity on cybersecurity. Initially, it will be a seminar. So we have just, during the pandemic, obviously a lot of our capacity building work cannot occur because a lot of our work is face-to-face on the ground. So we've established the Australia-Indonesia Virtual Transport Security Seminar Series. We've delivered one series on screener accreditation, and our next one is scheduled for May, and that will be on cybersecurity. We will have one of our staff from my headquarters in Canberra will come and deliver a presentation on Australia's journey and Australia's experience. So I think, I think perhaps we should stay in touch, and maybe you or some of your people at Curug may like to participate in that. That will be a virtual seminar, and I think it will be a great way to start. And after that, I'll be talking to DGCA about any future activities to progress on the cyber front. But hopefully you'll be able to participate in that and find a little bit more about Australia's experience.
Okay, thank you, Ms.
Lewis. I'm glad we could invite on that.
Makasih.
Sorry, Mr. Hemi, because Mr. Lewis, Miss Lewis has another agenda, and then also the time is almost running out. So there is one more question from the lecturer as well. There is Iputu Diva, the lecturer from Land Transportation Polytechnic from Bali. For Mr. Putu Diva, time is yours.
Thank you for the time. I'm Putu Diva. I would like to ask a question. There are some general problems such as security related to passenger terminals in Indonesia. Thus, many passengers are reluctant to enter the terminal. Until now, many regulations have been formulated by the government regarding passenger terminal, such as the passenger terminal design, which resembles with an airport design, but the implementation has not been optimal. My question is, how are the security arrangements at the passenger terminals in your country? Can you explain to us?
This is your in Australia.
Thank you.
Okay, Miss Lewis.
Izin Bapak, can you please repeat again the question because it's not really clearly good.
Mass public transport
users. How are the security arrangements at the passenger terminal in your country?
Is he talking about a cruise terminal or what's he talking about?
Is it cruise terminal or airport terminal in Australia or?
Bus station terminal.
Okay.
Right.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
Yeah.
So you've managed to ask a question on land transport that I'm least knowledgeable in, but let's think about it. So our bus terminals are not that busy either. So in Australia, there's not a lot of, just trying to think, there's in our smaller cities, there's not a lot of security like we have at the airports. So I'm not really sure what to share with you there. So I don't think bus terminals are very regulated to a high degree in Australia. There's no sort of screening when you go into a terminal. Most of them are outdoors. So I guess you can pretty much get on a bus with anything. So I don't think Australia has the best experience to share in bus terminals. So you mentioned Bali. Was there a particular issue that you are aware of or that you're watching to think that something needs to be addressed?
Yes.
I think, so you're talking about security, safety, personal safety?
Yes. Mr. Butu.
Okay.
Yes,
so,
miss.
Yeah.
Mr. Butu, are you copied? Are you there? Okay. Okay, I think that's enough. The signal is very poor.
A lot of security issues in there.
Okay.
Apply that.
Okay. I think we skip for the Mr. Putu as a lecturer. So I think because the time is up, so for the question and answer session, I will end this time. And also after this, thank you very much for the presentation and for the answer from Ms. Lewis. Once again, give applause for Ms. Lewis. Thank you so much. And then after this, the committee has already told me that we will deliver for the certificate of appreciation for Mr. Lewis and then also, for Ms. Lewis. Mrs. Julie Lewis, certificate of appreciation. I saw in this script is Miss Lewis. Okay, I'm sorry, Mrs. Lewis. Okay.
It is Miss.
Okay, so we will continue to the next session. It's the photographs or photo session, photo together with the all participants. Until now, the participants is 924 participants.
Wow.
Okay, for amazing. The committee, please arrange for the photo session. Should we stand up or still sit here? Okay. Okay, please count it. One, two, three. Three times. One, two, three. Once again, all cadets should open the, the video or profile, image profile. Do not hide the profile so that we can see your face with handsome and pretty face. Okay, one, mas. One, two, three. Okay, thank you very much. Give applause for everyone. Well, thank you, Ms. Lewis. This is very interesting topics and agenda, and so for the interesting and excellent presentation. Regards to your family and your colleagues, and then also thank you very much and forgive if there is any mistake or manner from us. Thank you, Ms. Lewis. Have a nice day.
Terima kasih. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. So, there is a nice presentation from Mrs. Lewis. So, the next agenda, according to our schedule, is the discussion session from Mr. Insinyur Heri Sudarmaji, KIA, DAA. Okay, I will read the curriculum vitae for Mr. Heri Sudarmaji. So, Mr. Heri Sudarmaji, DAA, Insinyur Heri Sudarmaji, DAA, KIA, is the head of Air Transportation Human Resources Development Center at Curug, and then the story of the experience of Mr. Heri Sudarmaji from 2006 until now is a lecturer with a head lecturer at Civil Aviation Polytechnic at Surabaya, and then at 2009 until 2014 as the director of Civil Aviation Academy at Makassar, and then 2014 until 2015 is the head of planning division at the Human Resources Development Training Agency, and 2015 until 2016 is the general inspector at Ministry of Transportation, and 2016 until 2018 is the Inspector 5 at the General Inspectorate at Ministry of Transportation, and then 2018 until 2019 is Inspector 4 at the General Inspectorate of Minister of Transportation. And then the last is 2019 until now is the head of Air Transportation Human Resources Development Center at Curug. So this is the discussion session. So there is no question and answer for the participants. So this is the wrap-up meeting or the final speaker from Mr. Insinyur Heri Sudarmaji, DAA. For Insinyur Heri Sudarmaji, DAA, KIA, as a discussion, the time is yours now.
Thank you, Mr. Kenny. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Good afternoon. Salam sejahtera bagi kita semua. Salam. Om Swastiastu, Namo Buddhaya, salam kebajikan. The Honorable Mr. Yugi Ardiman, Secretary of Human Resource Development on Transportation Agency, and Mr. Geni as a moderator, and all of ambassadorial lecture participants. First of all, I say thank you to all participants. that today we can gather in this activity in a good condition. Ladies and gentlemen, in this moment, I would like to appreciate First Secretary Australian Embassy in Jakarta, Mrs. Julie Lewis, for a very good and comprehensive explanation about enhancing transport security awareness. I want to resume of her presentation. Firstly, she talked about relationship Australia-Indonesia focus on transport security capability building and renewal MOU on transport security in February 2020 with cooperation program about aviation and maritime security. And then she talked about threat to maritime and aviation, preventive security and security awareness, and then global security culture campaigns about security awareness and culture, and then developing security culture. And the last but not least, she explained how can you enhance transport security awareness. Firstly, see something, and then second, hear something, and third is report it. I want to give some information to all that regulation about aviation security awareness in Indonesia is referred to IQ Annex 17 about safeguarding international civil aviation against acts of unful interference. And then IQ document H973 about security manual. And then aviation law number 1/2009 about civil aviation, and minister regulation number 51/2020 about national aviation security, and the last minister declare number 211/2020 about national aviation security program. Another then, an example in aviation security awareness is important as a campaign and preventive acts to ensure that prohibited item such as weapon, dangerous good article, explosive and dangerous good are not carried on the aircraft cabin, since those items may dangerous the flight operation. And then about the question and answer, I note the question from Cadet Irland. It is very interesting for me how to increase the awareness of transportation, human resources, and the public on important to transportation security. My opinion, to increase the awareness of human resources and public on the importance of transportation security are through campaigns, social media, seminar, workshop, and also training, etc. And in addition, it is not only transportation personnel who are responsible for security awareness, but all of level society, such as religious leader, community leader, artists, should be involved to increase security awareness. And the most important, cadet should become pioneer and taking part in increasing security awareness. Ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, I hope that this lecture will give more benefit to the development of education and training in transportation, especially for our cadet, as the next generation in Indonesia, transportation that will be work in regulator, operator, and industry. Thank you for your attention. Good afternoon. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much for Mr. Insinyur Heri Sudarmaji, DAAKA, as a discussion. That is the end of our lecture, ambassadorial lecture, with fostering the theme enhancing transport security awareness. Okay. Give applause for Mr. Insinyur Heri Sudarmaji as a discussion. And now the last session is the closing statement from Mr. Masrono Yugi Hartiman. The time is yours. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. This is a sum note, summary actually, to sum up of our session today. Cadet, participant, and ladies and gentlemen, we have heard already the presentation from Mrs. Julie Lewis. She is the First Secretary of Australian Embassy, Transport Attaché. I hope you all could absorb and give view on the management of security in transportation sector in Australia. And also, we also have some cooperation actually between Australia and Indonesia since 2005. Government has been established and conducted in actually in a mutual and beneficial base fashion. This has been mentioned by Ms. Julie Lewis, that both countries have conducted cooperation, especially in the field of transport security, and also has performed several programs under the scheme of cooperation. Today's event is focused on the issue of security in the transportation sector. Why this topic is very important? You can see that as shown on the presentation, there are some many threats to transportation sector, inland transport, sea transport, as well as civil aviation. Therefore, to materialize a safe, secure, environment-friendly transportation in Indonesia, we need to solve and overcome this security problem. One of the strategy is by enhancing our awareness of security issues. To enhance the awareness, cadet have to understand the standard by learning Mr. Harry thought that some document and annex from ICAO. I think in this campus, you have the substances related to the national and international standard of security in the transport sector. We also could enhance our awareness by developing our culture, our way of life, so that the threat also could be detected earlier. And the more important is how we could contribute it. We could contribute to the enhancement of the security awareness in the transport sector. For instance, if we see something, hear something, and also something suspicious, actually, we should report it to the officer or to authorized agency nearby. I think that is all from me for my closing statement. But I think that some, I still have one note, actually. As Mr. Harris said, that from the question of the cadet, for me, that the cadet saw the eagerness to know something, you should maintain this spirit and character. You said you should have, as young people said, the kipo, kipo. Kipo is knowing everything particular object. I mean that you should kepo, but in a good way, not in a bad way. Kepo, know every particular object. You should have eagerness, character, the spirit to know something. I think that's all my closing. The thing should be always to enhance is the awareness of security, then how develop a security as a culture, as a way of life. Thank you very much. That is my closing statement. Thank you, Park, all cadet, also all trainer, lecturer, sorry, and official. Thank you very much. Very good afternoon.
Thank you very much for the closing statement from the Secretary of Human Resources Agency. Mr. Yuki Hartiman. And then that is the end of the main session today, this afternoon. Once again, thank you. Oh, okay. The committee said that there is another closing statement from Mrs. Lewis. Okay. Can you hear me, yes, sir. Mrs. Lewis? Okay. Time is yours for the closing statement.
I just would like to say thank you, Bapak Gudi, for the closing remarks. I have very much enjoyed being here today. It was a little bit of a rush. We've had a very busy week, but it's events like these that I really do enjoy participating in. I think they're very important. It's the future of our workforce that are attending the academy, and to be able to share some thoughts so that we can maybe increase our own security awareness is a great opportunity. Thank you again for kindly inviting me. I look forward to perhaps visiting your academy and Turak at some point in the future, or perhaps coming back and delivering again. So once again, thank you so much to Makasi, and stay safe.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much. Give applause for Mrs. Lewis and Mr. Yuki Hartiman. And so that is all the main session, the end of main session. Well, once again, thank you very much for Mrs. Lewis, and thank you very much for Mr. Nasrono Yuki Hartiman, and then also thank you very much for Mr. Heri Sudarmaji, and also for all of the participants, our beloved cadet, and also all the distinguished guests who has attended until today. Until now, there is still more than 800 participants still exist in this afternoon. So, once again, I'm sorry if there is any unmeaned or bad words or bad unacceptable. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, give applause. Okay, hopefully there is a benefit for us. And then also just remember, see something, hear something, and report it. Okay, back to Mrs. Gina as a MC. Thank you very much. Give applause for everyone.
Thank you, Mrs. Julie Lewis and Mr. Heri Sudarmaji for the ambassadorial lecture. And thank you, Mr. Yuki Hartiman, for the closing statement. And thank you, Mr. Geni Prasojo, for guiding the lecture very, very nicely and interactive. It was amazing event, and please give applause for all of us. Before we end this event, we would like to give the appreciation. The appreciation will be given to discussion. Mr. Heri Sudarmaji, Head of Civil Center for Human Resources Development on Civil Aviation from Human Resources Development on Transportation Agency. And then the next appreciation will be given to our moderator, Mr. Geni Prasojo, and the appreciation from Human Resources Development on Transportation Agency. So, ladies and gentlemen, finally, we come to the end of the event. We hope that what we get today will give us benefit and insight that will be useful for enhancing transport security awareness. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your time and your kind attention. I do really apologize if there are any mistake in presenting this event. Stay healthy and keep safe. Enjoy your day and see you next time. Good afternoon. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.